In this illustration, we'll study about horizontal circular motion supported by strings. Here, you can see the figure shows a bob moving in horizontal circular motion at angular speed twice of root 2g by h, where distance AB is equals to h, and we are required to find the ratio of tension the supporting strings T1 by T2, and we are given that the strings are inextensible and of equal length. Now, in this situation, if we first draw the free body diagram of M in rotating frame, then this can be seen here. This bob is experiencing mg in downward direction, centrifugal force m omega square are outward, and two tensions are acting onto it, which are acting at an angle theta with the vertical T1 and T2. And we can write for equilibrium of bob in rotating frame, for its horizontal equilibrium, we can write T1 sine theta plus T2 sine theta is equals to m omega square r, that is here first equation. And vertical direction, we can write T1 cos theta is equals to T2 cos theta plus mg, that is your second equation. Here, if we continue, then we can substitute the value of sin theta and cos theta. So, we can see from equation 2, we can write this T1 minus T2 is equals to mg by cos theta. Substituting the value of cos theta as this angle is theta here, we can write cos theta is h by 2 upon L. So, this will be 2 mg L by h. As we can write here, cos theta is equals to h by 2 L we are using. Similarly, from equation 1, we can write, this will give us T1 plus T2 is equals to m omega square r by sin theta. And as here the value of sin theta is equals to r by L, then on substituting this as r by L, it is m omega square L. We can further substitute the value of omega, which is given here as 2 root 2g by h. So here the value of T1 plus T2 becomes this ml multiplied by omega square, we can write as 8g by h. So, this is 8 mg L by h. Now, if we divide these two equations here, you can see, say if this is equation number 3 and this is equation number 4, then we can see dividing 3 by 4 will result as T1 minus T2 upon T1 plus T2. Is equals to 1 by 4. Further, if we cross multiply, it is 4 T1 minus 4 T2 is equals to T1 plus T2. So, in this situation, this is giving us, we can further simplify, and this is giving us 3 T1 is equals to 5 T2, and the value of T1 by T2 we are getting is 5 by 3. That will be the final result of this problem.